Freelance. So I take job offers as they arise. So when this guy called me, I was relieved I could finally get a paying job. He said he needed help with interior design for his house that he was building. I always respected people who can do construction, so I naturally agreed to come and take a look. I already had a couple of ideas. It was already quite late, but he insisted on me coming over the same day. I tried to comply, because I didn't want to lose this offer. I drove there with my car. His house was all the way over in the suburban area, quite remote, but with other houses nearby, quiet place. The man met me at the front gate. It was a temporary fence, and the gate was made of rotting wooden planks. He started showing me around the yard. It seemed weird that there was a large garbage container blocking the way, so we had to go through the garage to get inside the house. He took me through the rooms, so I started looking around. At one point, I saw a stain, and at first glance it seemed like brick dust. But then I realized it was blood, spilled on the floor. I thought that maybe there was another worker who got injured, so I turned to tell the man. That's when I saw his hand raised to hit me. He was holding a metal rod. Before I could defend myself, he hit me in the head. I must have passed out. I don't know how long I was out. When I woke up,
that hurt.
I can't get further. There's no... Why would he hit me and then lock me in here? phone is smashed. No way it's gonna work anytime soon. This bloodstain does not look like it's the result of a banal injury. This looks like something was being dragged across the bloodstain. See, better look some more. The rod is loose. The rod is loose. The rod is loose. Thank you. might be able to get further through the attic. Shit, it's dark. What the hell was that? There we go. The handle is not in place. It's holding with the wires. It's holding with the wires. It's stuck underneath the beam. Thank you. stuck underneath the beam. It's stuck underneath the beam. Going back through here. I don't even want to go back.
The fuse box opener is locked in the old house in my duffel bag.
The dragging stain again. I don't like the look of that dark corridor. Let's see if the light switch is working. Finally, out of the house. Dark rooms. Locked. Locked. Broken.
13, July 2001. Subject: Final Reminder Letter. Dear.
This must be one of the three suspension ladders mentioned in the letter. Why is everything always locked? Why is everything always locked? She's dead. I don't want to look at her face. It's the address of this house. Was she invited here too? Why is everything always locked?
The fuse box opener is locked in the old house in my duffel bag.
Useful here? What's this? Ah, I believe this thing can open fuse boxes. These are already on.
Honey, if the circuit trips again, first
These are already on. Locked. 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 Scary. Jesus. Get away from me!
There he is! This is Lightwater Police. Stay where you are. You're under arrest. Get down on your knees.
But I didn't do anything.
Get on your knees, now! You are under arrest.
This is what happened. He was chasing me with a rod in his hand. He must have hidden when he saw the police cars pulling up to the gate.
Mr. Malcolm, we searched the yard thoroughly and didn't find any evidence suggesting there was another man.
No. He was there. He was the owner who called me.
The former owners sold the house due to personal financial problems 2 weeks ago. They moved to a different town on the other side of the country. The private company who owns it now proved all their employees were off-site, having a team-building activity that night.
How could you not find evidence of him? I'm telling you, he was there.
I heard you. Our officers got a phone call from one of the neighbors reporting lights coming on in the house and suspicion.
That's how it all began for me, and it was far from over.